With Flutter and Supabase, it's easy to create real-time apps that react to the changes happening on your database. Hi there! In this video, we're going to take a look at the real-time feature that Supabase offers and how we can use them in our Flutter applications. Currently, Supabase offers three different types of real-time features. Postgres changes, which is used to listen to your changes on your database. Presence, which is used to listen to who is present on your app. And broadcast, which is used to share low latency real-time data between clients without bypassing your databases. We're going to take a look at the Postgres changes and leave the other two for another time. Let's dive in. By default, the real-time feature is disabled for all tables and you can enable real-time on a per-table basis. From your Supabase dashboard, go to Database, Replication, Supabase Real-Time, and select the table you want real-time to be turned on. The Supabase Flutter library provides two ways to listen to real-time Postgres changes, stream and unsubscribe. Both can be used to listen to changes happening on your tables. The difference between the two is that stream provides the initial data as well as the ongoing changes on the database, whereas unsubscribe only fires callbacks for events that happen after establishing a connection. If you want to, for example, display a list of chat messages, using stream will be easier. Constructing a stream is easy. You just call from and pass a table you want to listen to and call stream on it. You have to pass the list of primary key columns of the table, which a lot of the times is just ID. The resulting stream will return you a list of map of string dynamic upon listening to it. You can also apply a filter to narrow down your results. As of the time of this recording, supported filters include the following, but check out our docs for the latest list. You can also add order and limit clause to further optimize the data you want to receive. A typical stream query for listening to messages in a chat room could look something like this. Just pass this to the stream builder and you have a UI for the list of messages. Now moving on to unsubscribe. Unsubscribe is actually what is being used by the stream method under the hood and is a lower level way to access Supabase's real-time feature. The way you construct a unsubscribe callback is to call channel, on, and pass Postgres changes as a type. Channel here can be anything as long as it's unique across your app. Now channel filter is where we specify more details about what changes we want to listen to. Event specifies what event you want to listen to, and can be all, insert, update, or delete. Schema specifies the schema of the table you want to listen to and typically should be public. Table is the table you want to listen to. You can also omit the table parameter to listen to changes happening in all real-time enabled tables. Filter is where you pass filters to further narrow down the events you want to listen to. The same sets of filters are available as the stream method. Within the callback, the payload will contain new and old map of the changed row. A good use case of using unsubscribe would be when you want to show a dialog or snack bar reacting to changes in the database. You might want to, for example, show a snack bar within your app when a new message was inserted while your user had the app opened. And that is how you can use Supabase real-time with Flutter. See you next time in another video of Flutter and Supabase.